Welcome to the Art of Time. I'm Pooh.
And I'm William Cooper.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'll be in to tuck you in just a little bit.
All right.
1 hour, to be exact.
1 hour?
1 hour.
That's a lot.
Sounds like it, doesn't it?
Yep.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night.
See you later.
Bye.
Don't forget to read me a bedtime story.
Okay, I will.
Bye.
You pick one out, okay?
All right, bye.
Bye. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you've been listening to some of the music that we play on this broadcast a lot. And you don't always know where it comes from. Well, tonight you're going to meet the man responsible for this. everything hooked up here right, I give you the Aaron. Russo. Good evening, Aaron.
Tonight.
Are you there?
Thank you. It's very kind of you. I haven't heard that stuff in so long, I can't believe it. It put a tear to my eye.
Well, good. You deserve the recognition, I believe. And
thank you.
You also did Trading Places?
Yes, I did.
You're also the founder of the Constitution Party?
Yes.
Which has sort of become inactive and neutralized after some shenanigans by some people that we won't get into that tonight because we've got a lot of other stuff to talk about.
A lot of very positive things to talk about.
Wonderful.
I think the Constitution Party will become very positive again in the future. I really believe that. And I think we have a vehicle in place so that when the opportunity strikes, and I think it will soon, it's there to move on. And I certainly know one thing, its platform and what it stands for is better than anything else out there in the marketplace. And what I've done since I resigned from the Constitution Party, you know, is I've put Mad as Hell together. And Mad as Hell is just unbelievable. And it's taken off across America. And I feel so confident of Mad as Hell that I just think we're going to, I think, I finally have hope that we can actually win. You know, when I was with the Constitution Party, you know, people always complain, well, do I have to give up the Republican Party and do I have to stop being a Democrat? And, you know, it was like a political party and people thought of it as a very staid kind of thing. People are always afraid to leave and go to other parties. But Mad as Hell is an organization that I formed that people are just signing on. They're not afraid of it. They're signing on by the thousands because Mad as Hell, instead of being a political party, is something I started to fight totalitarianism because that's the real battle we have in America. And if we can make everybody in America aware that we're living in a police state and that this country and its ideals have been burned and put aside and been shredded. It's like the Constitution has been shredded. And if I can make people across America aware of that by using my skills as a movie producer, then I thought that was the best thing I could do. And once you get millions of people involved in Mad as Hell, then the Constitution Party can pick up where it left off. And that's my plan.
Now, when you left, you were going to make a movie and you were going to make a TV series.
Right.
What happened to those two projects?
Well, the movie, I had a movie I was working on called Dangerous Precedent, which about the IRS and the 16th Amendment, and nobody would make the movie. I mean, I tried very hard to get that movie done, and nobody would make it. And in the process of making the TV show, I went ahead and I had very extensive negotiations, actually, with the Walt Disney Company. And they wanted the show, but we didn't agree. And I said to them, listen, guys, you know, if I'm fighting the federal government, I don't want to be a slave to them. I'm not going to become a slave to the Walt Disney Company. So what happened was I went ahead and slave-assed it myself. I paid for the thing. I shot the show. And it's evolved into this amazing video called Aaron Russo's Mad as Hell. And it's 90 minutes long. And if I do say so, and I say this modestly, it's really brilliant. It's wonderful. I mean, it's the best thing I've ever done in my life because it's better than Trading Places or The Rose or anything I've ever done because it's about something really important. The content is just wonderful. It's educating people to what's going on in America. Being a Jewish guy, people know I'm not anti-Semitic, you know, which is a big plus. And being a very successful movie producer and winning Emmys and Tonys and Academy Award nominations, they know that they can't call me some wild radical out of the Idaho or Montana hills. And so because I made this, people who know I am are watching the show. And they're closing my daughter, and I had no idea this was going on in America. I had no idea. And we're selling thousands and thousands of these videos. And what I've done...